So Jesse, I know we use a lot of Mitsubishi tooling for this project. You talked a lot with them. Can you tell everyone why you chose them and what the advantages are?
Yeah, sure. As we both know, Adam originally cut this part on our VF2SS over here, and he was using generic tooling that he ordered from an online source. He had some struggles with that. We definitely heard that machine, you know, squeaking and squawking and some chatter. And when we went to go from a small little test batch to making 200 of these things for the HTEC event this year, we really had to move this over to our 5-axis machine and optimize the process. We had to cut down on cycle time, and we needed the ability to engrave on all faces of this part, right? That would have been even more setups on our VF2 over here. So as part of that optimization, I reached out to our partners at Mitsubishi Materials for some tooling better suited for this application. Utilizing their exchangeable head IMX series and a dia edge insert mill, we were able to significantly cut down on cycle time. A side benefit was that the surface finish and overall part quality was significantly better. Let's check out a few features on these IMX exchangeable head end mills. For this project, we're utilizing a 3/8 and 1/2 inch tool. These heads have a corner rad and 3 flutes and are specifically engineered for aluminum alloys. The tool's polished rake face and sharp cutting edge allow for high efficiency machining, even though we're running dry for video purposes here. We also had some unfavorable projection lengths needed to cut these internal fillets on the part here, and the tool did a great job eliminating the chatter that Adam was seeing over on the VF2. Ben, can you pull that 1/2 inch IMX out and we'll take a look at it? Shrink is always a nice upgrade, but usually it becomes more time consuming when you're changing tools. You gotta run over to the shrink machine, heat up the holder, swap out a solid carbide tool. These tend to be a little faster.
Yeah, these Mitsubishi tools make it easy to swap cutting edges. Pull the tool out, put it on a bench, and swap heads using the provided wrench. Essentially, making that carbide shank part of the holder, and to swap the tool is easier and more repeatable than a collet.
Absolutely. There's also a slight taper along the shank of these IMX heads, and then it bottoms out on this polished end face here. So once the new head is in, you put the tool back in the spindle and you're ready to cut. It's definitely faster than going over to that shrink machine. Speaking of fast, let's pull up that AXD insert mill and take a look at that. Mitsubishi says the high performance we are seeing is in large part to the superior resistance to wear and fracturing of the GM series insert. The rake face of the tool has a special mirror finish treatment to prevent welding and improve reliability and tool life. That's critical for this project as we're running production dry in aluminum 6061. Ben hasn't had to flip the inserts yet as the tool life has been phenomenal. But when it's time, there are 2 cutting edges on each insert. One unique feature that we immediately noticed are these double clamping screws. Typical inserts have one hole, but this setup helps prevent the insert from movement caused by extreme centrifugal force at high speeds. Ben, why don't we throw this back into the spindle and see what it does? We can talk a little bit about the body design as well.
Sure, I'll pull the facing program off.
Mitsubishi specifically designed this AXD series for high-speed, efficient milling of aluminum and titanium alloys. We are just using it to face in this application, but is engineered for multifunctional milling, from pocketing, shoulder milling, helix boring, and even surface machining. This design is also balanced to prevent vibration to G6.3 or better at 10,000 RPM. Though we aren't really taking advantage of it here, this tool is also capable of excellent wall finish and accuracy due to its design. We pushed things really hard here and still got a great finish, and I think it would be fair to say the limiting factor wasn't the tool or the insert. The last 2 Mitsubishi tools that Ben used were from their solid carbide line, an MP series ball end mill with a very short length of cut, and a solid carbide leading drill intended for centering and chamfering. We had a lot of logos to put in the part, and Mitsubishi actually recommended using this carbide drill for this. This was an interesting solution, as a typical single flute engraving cutter can often be a pain for us, especially when running dry. The drill features a unique tip geometry with a thinning pocket that promotes smooth chip evacuation and excellent hole position accuracy in a drilling application. With the ultra-sharp cutting edge and high fracture resistance, this drill is giving us excellent wear resistance. So far, this lead drill has a lot of time on it, engraving the 5 unique logos on these parts. The Mitsubishi Dia Edge logo, the Haas logo, Cam Instructor, 5th Axis, and Master Cam logos sure make this part a little more special. Finally, we are using the ball end mill to deburr this part right on the machine. Let's get that running. Ben went over programming this in an earlier video, but can you run that again?
Sure.
I absolutely love the motion that MasterCam produces with deburr. The only thing I love more is that we are not deburring 200 of these by hand. If this were a paid job and not just an event giveaway, it could certainly erase the profit margin on a simplistic part like this. Not to mention, it is way too easy to scrap out the part on the last deburr hand operation. On-machine deburring is certainly helpful on any part, but in a high production setting, it is even more critical. So after programming and running this part, midway through our production cycle here, there is no way we want to go back to the old generic tooling or the manual flip in a typical 6-inch vise on our 3-axis machine. Moving this job to the UMC 750 SS and utilizing the 5th axis tombstone and the quality Mitsubishi tooling has saved us countless machine hours and part quality issues. We are now on schedule to deliver these parts in time for the event, and once we got things proven out, we brought our scrap rate to zero. Every press of the cycle start button, we get 2 beautifully finished parts.